most of the things in Ayurveda, they are connected with mythology. While we deal with the Charitaka or Pramanika, there are two things. Charitaka deals with mythology, Pramanika deals with the technology. There is a problem in the Ayurveda like that. So most of the things are having deities connection or devatas connection. Something they are telling, some herbs which are available only in celestial planets. They are inducing lack of new mantras. They are inducing new process known as pranapratishtha, shapa vimochana, balidana, then punapranapratishtha, dikbandha, vimogha, kala nirnaya. Innumerable things are there. You must pluck the herb only at the time. You must chant this mantra, you must try this thing, you must worship this deity. So everything is like that. So we face the problems like that. Number one, arismology. Most of the things are in Paribhasha. Now what I told in recently on seminar, I told, there is no need of Paribhashas now. Paribhasha is not essential now, because even if it is transparently told, people are not capable of understanding and practicing. People, even though it's clearly you say that this is the thing, people have lost their vigor to truth. No need to hide truth. No need to hide the concepts of Ayurveda. Even if it is plain and transparent, nobody is ready to practice. Number one. And number two, demystification and deification of Ayurveda. Everything is connected with the God and Devata. Everything is connected with the mantra. So unless these things are understood, either you have to remove them and understand the herbs properly. Or if it is essential, if you consider, you must behave like that, you must practice that. You are practicing everything in the rasasala, rasayana sala. But in the antaryana, you have to practice nididhyasana, upasana, pujana, and everything, etc. If you believe that, practice. If you don't believe, remove that and extract and create a de novo system of materia medica in which there is no devata, mantra, pujana, vidhi, niyama, achara, and samskara. You remove all of these things. That is the second thing. Third thing is pulse diagnosis. For example, I want to say something. If you want to mainstream something, productivity must be assured. If productivity should be assured, diagnostic system should be assured. If diagnostic system is to be assured, then understanding of the system should be assured. If you don't have understanding of body, nature, the birth, etc., your diagnosis will be wrong, because the basic understanding of the system itself will be wrong. If the understanding of the system is wrong, your diagnosis is wrong. If your diagnosis is wrong, the treatment is wrong. If the treatment is wrong, productivity is wrong. I conduct a seminar within 1 or 2 months in which there are challenge all of you people, you are all admirers of Ayurveda. With you I cannot conduct that. 100 questions in Ayurveda which can be asked by these material medica people, model people, which we have to answer. I believe that nobody can answer, only few people they can answer. Pulse diagnosis, you have to prove, already I have told in 2 seminars, that you have to create a reverse simulation system or modeling system wherein by you have to understand the micro levels of signals which are classified into main level, sub level and sub sub level classifications, where we can understand which part it is reflecting. That sound reflects which part, which organ, which zone, which nerve and which part it is going to reflect. That it should be understood only by a reverse process. So by understanding this nadi and coming to a mechanical calculation or determination will take you hundreds of years. Nobody is now so capable to do that. So if you go by the reverse process, you understand the diseases first by a normal medical report, modern medical report, and try to interpret, try to connect the pulse signals with the available medical reports. Then you can produce medical reports after 50 or 100 exercises. I have suggested it in 2 seminars. Somebody should do that. One more problem is that hundreds of problems in Ayurveda, whatever they have told about the Sharira and various other things, they are totally incongruous to that of the modern medicine things. I'll say one example. It is about gender determination. That is Shukladhikyena Puman, Shronitadhikyena Strisyad. It is there in Shastras. Where the male content is more, the child will be male, and female content is more dominant, it will be female. But there is a very great opposition. One person in flight at Banaras, he has talked to me for 1.5 hours. According to modern science, the XY and XX system, as well as the XX, XO system, and ZW system, 3 systems are there, apart from haplodiploids. Haplodiploids is the 4th system. Apart from which, there are 3 systems. According to that, sex determination range Y is known as sex determination range Y syndrome is there. It is known as SRY. This SRY, which is having 60 million of base pairs, when it combines with something of its own kind, it becomes female, XX. If it is with Y, XY, it becomes a male. And the adaptability of X with a male, as well as XY being bivalent inside a male, if the X combines with the X of the female, it will be a female. If the X of the male combines with the Y, it will be a male. Like that, the second option I have told, it is XX giving you X O giving you. X X it gives you female. X O means that O it will not have a secondary sex determination factor. Secondary sex determination factor. SSDF will not be there. It is the second model. It is available in few cockroaches, grasshoppers, and some elements. It is available. XXXO model. The second is contrary. ZS, yes, ZZ that gives you male. XX gives female. But ZZ that gives male. Z and W that gives female. Apart from haplodiploids. So this is what the modern oology, spermatology, genetic engineering, life organization science, they say only like that. But Ayurveda has not told like that. Like that, we can give thousands of examples. But the Shastra say that Adhikya, if you say predominance, it means not the predominance of the fluid or the content or something. It is predominant of the factor. It is predominance of the factor. For example, a human being is bivalent. In male structure, it is having two things. One, it is having an option to create a male or female. It is having an option to create a male or female. And the female is having only the compatibility to access the male to be subjected to create a male or female. You found that? That is, compatibility is with the female, and the compatible design structure which is both qualified for male and female, X and Y, is rested with male. This Adhikya deals with the force. Adhikya need not be the substance. It is dealing with the force. So whenever a male in his XY standard, XY is the male standard, whenever a person imposes the same XY model, joining with the X of the female, XY is a male model, in this Adhikya, XY with the Y with the X model is XY model. That is a natural innate model of male. But here, in your fusion, that innate model is bi-represented. The innate represented model of male is XY. The fusion representation is also XY if the person is male. But the difference is, in that innate model, the X belongs to his own chromosomal status. And in the fusion model, the X belongs to the female status. But XY is the Adhikya of the Purusha Tattva, so it is becoming male. That XX, it gives the female. So Adhikya means not substantial, it is not substance domination, but substantial domination, so it is possible. I think that it requires more lights to be thrown and more discussions in later. Likewise, hundreds of visible transparent incongruities are there. If somebody asks a question, the Ayurvedic student or a scholar must be able to answer all of these questions. The other thing is microanatomy. Where is the chakra? Where are the points inside? All of these things are also very mysterious and known only through yoga and realization. Everything you say that you do penance, you will realize. You go to forest, close your eyes, you will realize. Then that should be practiced only in forest. So practicality, see, if you can show 50% by practical demonstration, even though not the base, but the effective functioning, other than 50% can be inferred. That is known as logical inference. If your thing is very much acceptable by perception, which is very much empirically practicable, rest of the things which are impalpable can be guided.